Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm not going to talk about how Mike Tyson knocked out Larry Holmes to avenge the loss that an out-of-prime Ali suffered in the hands of Holmes. I won't also be talking about how Big George Foreman knocked out Michael Moore in November 1994 to become the oldest heavyweight champion of the world, or how marvellous Marvin Hagler knocked out Thomas Hearn in the epic middleweight encounter in April 1985. These were all great fights, guys, no doubt about that. But today, I will be looking at the man who guided his son to become a two-time heavyweight champion of the world from a young age.
And that's Big John Fury, from whose balls I came from.
This man is popularly regarded as the Big John Fury, the father of the current WBC heavyweight champion of the world, Tyson the Gypsy King Fury. I will look into Big John's life from his time as a bare-knuckle boxer, some controversy surrounding him over the years, and his role in getting his son Tyson Fury to the elite level. But before we get going, please hit the subscribe button and the notification icon if you're new to my channel. The name Gypsy was originally his before his son Tyson Fury took it from him. Big John started as a bare-knuckle boxer before he went professional. John's boxing record isn't the best any man can have. Probably that is why he let Tyson Fury join the fight train at an early age. I believe that Big John needed his son to clear the shame his boxing record brought to the Fury dynasty. Having come from a family of giants and fighters, the one thing John could have asked for was a good boxing record of maintaining the family hype. But no, he failed. He never won a world title. John fought a total of 13 times as a professional and won 8 out of them. He screwed his only shot at the title when he lost to Neil Malpas in June 1989. Well, with this record, one may argue that the record is decent. But let's check this out, guys. John came from a family known for their fighting tradition. The last time we saw John Fury in the ring was 1995, when he lost against Steve Garber at the G-Max Centre in Manchester. So when Big John lost his last fight, he handed over the mantle to his son, Tyson. He personally trained Tyson from an early age until he turned pro. On the 23rd day of July 2011, Tyson Fury defeated the then British undefeated heavyweight Derek Chisola for the British and Commonwealth heavyweight titles at Wembley Arena in London. This win must have made John so proud of his son Tyson, but whatever joy he must have felt never lasted. John got himself into serious trouble in 2011. John Fury and prison. You know, from the event that put John into the prison, I can tell you that Big John is not a man you should mess with. In 2010, John Fury ran into an old friend, Othie Sykes, whom he had a 12-year age beef with at a car auction. At a bid to get back at his friend, John went for his eye. Being a big man of 6'3", not many men could stand him. Investigations reveal that John tried to gouge Othie's eyes out. He ended up leaving the man half blind. So he was charged to court and sentenced to 11 years imprisonment. This was a blow for John, who wanted to guide his son to the elite level in boxing. He was afraid that his son Tyson wouldn't be adequately guided if he went to prison. So he pleaded for clemency, and the judge reduced his term to 4.5 years. After Big John served 4.5 years in prison, he was later released. When he languished in jail, his son Tyson Fury kept on smashing one opponent after another. During this period, Tyson Fury fought off competition from Joey Abell, Derek Chisora for a second time, and Christian Hammer to face the then world heavyweight champion of the world, Vladimir Klitschko, in 2015. But a few months before his top heavyweight clash between his son and Klitschko, John Fury was released from prison. Tyson Fury went on to dethrone Klitschko as the best heavyweight in the world. You can imagine how Big John must have felt coming out of prison and his son winning the heavyweight championship. That must have been a lot for the man.
Heavyweight champion of the world! I said he'd fucking quit! I said it! No belief in John Fury!
Just a few weeks before Tyson Fury squared up against the hard-hitting Alabama-born Deontay Wilder for their first fight in 2018, the news was all over the media that John Fury would not be allowed into the United States. This visa denial bordered around some alleged criminal records. That ban meant that John would not be in his son's corner when he faced Deontay Wilder. Reacting to this, John said he knew that he'd been a naughty man, but was disappointed with the ban. He further responded to the ban in these words, "I'm very, very disappointed. There's a lot of worse people than me in America. I've not killed anyone, have I?" However, in the end, of course, Big Fury was very happy that Tyson won, and he famously said after the trilogy, "I didn't worry for a second. I know my son, and I knew he would win." Wrapping things up on today's episode, we can all see that Fury Sr. is not a man who has had an easy ride in life, but he managed to guide his son from a kid boxer to a pro. There are a lot of controversies that rocked his name, but we can say that he loves his family, that's for sure. So guys, that will be all for today. Hit that like button if you like my videos, and please smash the subscribe button and notification bell icon. Catch you guys in the next video.